So I guess the thing you have to think about in any given poker situation is that you're dealing with a lot of uncertainty, and it's all about how to make the best decision in any given moment. So the sort of first rule of thumb is how to extract the most money or chips from your opponent when you have a strong hand, and how to lose the minimum when you have a weak hand. You're never going to be 100% certain which, you know, where you are. Are you beating them, or are you? Do you have a worse hand? So you have to sort of construct a strategy that is mathematically optimal in each situation. I guess people tend to think of intuition as their gut. Their gut instinct, and my rule of thumb in poker is to only fall on my gut instinct if my sort of logical, my slow brain, you know, the system two as it's sometimes called, has not come to a conclusive answer. A lot of people are tempted to just go, ah, this is too tricky, I don't know, and then go, yep, well, my gut instinct said this, I'm going to go with that. But the best thing to do is to work with both, your sort of slow brain and that gut. So you'll say you're playing against your opponent and you've noticed that actually there's someone who's very solid, they never seem to bluff, and you might have a hand that you would normally call with, say, 90% of the time, but you know this guy is just, he's just never bluffing, never doing it. Well, actually, this might be one of those rare situations where you do throw your hand in the muck, where you have a very strong feeling. You're just not like calling, even though mathematically it says you should call. You shouldn't do it. So the real, I guess, the art part of poker is when you have these flashes of inspiration where you need to deviate from the maths. And the science is knowing how often you should, you know, whether that deviation is the right thing to do at the time. When it comes to your intuition as a poker player, I would say do use it from time to time, but it should not be your starting point. As a rule of thumb, should always go for the slow method, system two analysis. See what answer that comes up with, and then also check in with your gut. Say you're in a really big hand and your opponent has bet. Often I'll have an instinctive response. I'll be like, oh, that's a bluff, or oh, that's they have a really strong hand, and I'll make a note of it. I won't just go with that answer. I'll go, okay. Now let's work through the mathematics, let's look sort of through all the other bits of information, what have they done on other cards and so on, and then see if those two answers match up. Now if they both match up, great, I've got an easy decision, but if one is giving a conflicting answer to the other, then usually you tend to rely on the sort of the mathematics, the logic part. However, if it's still really, really close with the mathematics, then I'll fall back on that gut instinct. But as a rule of thumb, your gut is not as reliable as you think. You know, you often see these like memes on the internet, which is like, always go with your gut, trust your instincts and so on. And I personally think that's a cop out. I think that's often the lazy way out for just when we are faced with a really tough decision in life, of just going, oh, well, you know, answer X. You know, our brains are very, they love to like to simplify things, to do things in black and white, but we live in a very complex world, and that does not, you know, that's not always the best route to take. So in a nutshell, your gut instincts can be useful, but as a last resort. We've evolved these amazing brains for a reason, so we should be using them.